What is up, you guys? This is Mini Superheroes Today.
Hey guys, Jonathan here, aka Mini Superheroes Today, and I have a different video for you today. So today we're actually going to be taking a look at an app on the App Store. So you can see some footage of it right here, but I got to tell you the story of how it panned out. So I follow LSW Misprint Collector over on Instagram, and he collects Lego Star Wars misprints. Bet you couldn't have guessed that. But anyways, he put up in his Instagram story not too long ago about this app here, and it's basically an all-in comprehensive look at every Lego Star Wars minifigure to date. And he's going to continue updating it, and it's a great way to fill out your collection and figure out what exactly you have in your collection. Now, I would love to see one for superheroes as well, obviously with my channel here, but I do have a lot of Star Wars figures, and I figured, you know what, this would be a really cool app to check out, so I messaged him, got some more info, and it is a fantastic app. So I'm gonna drop a link in the description where you can check it out, and let's dive in and take a closer look at what all this app can actually do.
Okay, so how it works is you see everything right here, and obviously you just go ahead and jump into the app as you see it. So you can do things several different ways. As you see here, all the minifigures are actually alphabetically ordered, or here you can go by number, which of course is by the code that you see underneath each name. So it's a very cool way to, you know, get around and see what figures are all in here. And then on this third tab, you can actually look at your collection. So I went through last night and actually mapped out everything I own, and as you can see, I have 649 Star Wars minifigures out of the about 1,200 total, if you really jack it up and round up. But anyways, it is very, very cool to go back and look at all the figures that I have in my collection, and you can also make a wanted list. So these are the minifigures that I most want. We'll circle back here in a minute. I just kind of want to show you all of the features here. So jumping back over to alphabetical order, let's start with the A's, Ayla Secura. So if we click on her, you can see that this is the Clone Wars version of the figure right under her name up there. And you can actually see a front and back view of the figure. So you just swipe in the middle of the screen to do that. Then underneath that, on the left side, it gives you the minifigure code according to Bricklink. To the right of that, it tells you the year it came out. And underneath that, it actually tells you which set it's found in. So then underneath there, you could click this little arrow to make it green if you have her in your collection, which I don't. So I'm going to leave that marked red since I don't have her. Or next to it, you can click this wanted, which adds it to your wanted. And this is a cool figure, so hey, I might as well say I want it in my collection. So after you go through all of that, you can actually swipe right to see the next figure, which of course will be the next figure chronologically of that character. So we got Ayla Secura in 2010 for the first time, and then we got her again in 2017 in another set, as you can see, and all the details will update. So as you swipe to the right, you'll get the next character kind of in, you know, chronological order, if you do number thing, or if you do the actual names, here it's alphabetical order. So it's very cool, and again, front and back for everybody, and then if you click this up in the top left, it obviously sends you back out, and you can go all the way through. Now, I do want to talk about some of the things about the app that I'm not exactly crazy about, and you know, it's a really great app for what it is, but there are little things like, if a figure, like, take it, for example, these battle droids, right? To me, a battle droid is a battle droid is a battle droid. So this version is from 1999 and is the one that had this 1x2 brick on the back for, like, its kind of comms backpack. But then if we move to the right, it's exactly the same figure, just without the back plate. To me, if you have one of these, you technically have both because they're the same figure. But according to Bricklink, they are two completely different figures. So I understand why the app doesn't merge these, but I kind of wish it would because, you know, again, if you have this version of the figure, you absolutely have this version of the figure too. So, I don't know, it just seems, it seems kind of contrived to break them up, but I do get why it does that. So, the reason that annoys me is, when I go over to my collection, and I see it says that I have 649 figures out of the 1,143 possible, that really bothers me because technically I have more than that, you know, like this Darth Maul, for example. There's also a variant with Darth Maul that is the exact same figure you see here, just without the cape. Well, if you have the one with the cape, you technically have the one without the cape, but then you would have to mark that you have two figures, and I think you guys get my point. It's just a little redundant that you would have to technically mark you have both if you wanted to go for the quote-unquote completion shortest route or the shortest route between those two. So that's really my only complaint. The other thing that I would say is in the bottom right corner, it says bonus series. And I actually asked Misprint Collector when he was developing this app what that means. And these are actually all like kind of obscure variant figures. So there's this with the different torso printing. This Palpatine has lines on his torso. This is a different Commander Fox. This Dooku has a darker gray beard, and so on. So these are just kind of some like miscellaneous, you know, variants and things like that that are out there, like the Stormtrooper, for example. So I figured I would just point that out, that that's one of the things that I don't particularly like about this app. But overall, the idea that you can catalog your collection on your phone, you know, if you are at a Comic Con or you're at a toy store that has Lego figures for sale and you need a quick reference of what you actually have or what you actually need, that's really good. So I really like this app. I hope that he makes one for the Lego Superheroes line. That would be great too, but I know this is a lot of work. So I'm just going to jump over to my collection, do a quick scroll here so you guys could see what I have in my collection. I definitely have a lot of the older stuff, you know, from growing up. So that's very, very cool. It looks really, really awesome. You don't want to see my whole collection, I guess. And if you did, I'll make a video on it. You could drop a comment and let me know. My wanted list is pretty cool. I have 58 figures on my wanted list. The Chrome Stormtrooper. Who else is on? Oh, you can't scroll this way. Dang. Okay, so Cloud City Luke Skywalker, Cloud City Lando, Aayla Secura you saw from earlier. I really want this Chrome Darth Vader from 2009. I really want Clone Commander Wolf. I've had this figure twice in its entirety except for the helmet, which is really annoying. I'd love to get this, but I'm not going to pay the crazy price for it, of course. So some of the stuff that I want here isn't even all that rare, you know, some of it's Comic-Con stuff, but some of it is just stuff along the way that I haven't picked up. So anyways, guys, I think that this is a great app. I highly suggest it, and, let's round out and I'll give you my final thoughts.
All right, guys. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video. Needless to say, I am a huge, huge fan of this app and everything it has to offer. So don't forget to check out the link in the description below where I'll link the app itself, as well as LSW Misprint over on Instagram, where you can check out his pretty amazing misprint collection. Anyways, drop a comment below, let me know what you think of this video, and let me know if you think you have more Star Wars minifigures than I do. I know I have a lot, but I also know there are some people out there that have, like, everything. So drop a comment, let me know, and I'll see you guys on the next video. If you liked what you saw and you liked what you heard, feel free to click that subscribe button for more LEGO content coming in the near future. So, thanks for tuning in to today's video, and until next time, build on.